And welcome to quantitative aptitude video from careerright.com. In this video, we would be dealing with problems on volumes, which is a very tedious topic, can throw some tricky questions in time-bound examinations, and can prove to be a lot of problem-causing subject for students who are not well prepared. Now, these kind of questions can be asked in bank exams, B-school exams, or exams conducted by government body. We would be touching up five different kind of problems from this topic, and by the end of the video, you would be in a comfortable position when dealing with the problems from this topic in future. So let's begin. The first question: water sprinkler sprinkles the water on flower pots and fills the ground by 4 cm of rainfall. Now the volume of the water that falls on the rectangular garden whose length and breadth is 40 and 60 meter respectively is, we need to find out the volume of the water. So the total area can be calculated just because length and breadth are given, 40 and 60. So 40 into 60 goes up to 2400 meter square. We got the area of the rectangular garden. Now 4 centimeter of the rainfall is the depth of the water. So firstly we will convert this centimeter into meter. So 4 by 100, just because 100 centimeters goes to forming 1 meter. So 1 by 25 meter would be the depth. Now to calculate the volume of the water which accumulated on ground would be, we would multiply area by depth. So 2400 into 1 by 25 forms 96 meter cube. This is the answer. Second question: 44 cubic centimeter of silver is drawn into wire 2 millimeter in diameter. Length of the wire in meters will be, let the length of wire be h as assumed, then radius would be, now the diameter given is 2 and we will divide to get the radius 2 by 2 millimeter, so that would be 1 millimeter. Now we would convert it to centimeter just because the volume is given in cubic centimeters. So 1 millimeter would be 0.1 centimeter just because there are 10 millimeters in 1 centimeter. The volume's formula is pi r square h. We have got the volume 44, got the r 0.1 into 0.1. We need to find out the h, the length of the wire. So the h can easily be found out, 1400 centimeter, that means 14 meter. This would be the answer. Now the third question: a hollow steel rod is 28 cm long and its external diameter is 10 cm. If the thickness of the pipe is 1 cm and iron weighs 6 g per cubic centimeter, then what is the weight of the rod? Now first, we need to find out the external radius and internal radius. Well, diameter is 10 cm, so divided by 2, we get the external radius 5. But for internal radius, we need to keep in mind that the thickness of the pipe is 1 cm, so we would subtract 1 from 5 cm, we would get the internal radius is 4 cm. So this would be R1, this would be R2. So to find the volume, the formula here would be pi R1 square minus R2 square into 28, that is the length of the hollow steel rod. So we get the volume as 792 cm cube. Now we know that every 1 cm cube weighs 6 gram, so 792 cm would weigh 792 into 6, 4752 gram, that is 4.75 kg. That would be the answer. Now the fourth question: the slant height of right circular cone is 13 meter and its height is 12 meter. Find the area of its curved surface. Now we know that it is right circular cone, so we can easily go on and apply Pythagoras theorem here. That would be r square is equal to l square minus h square. We have got the slant height l, that is 13 meter, and we have got the height, that is 12 meter, and it is a right circular cone. So 13 square minus 12 square, we get r square is equal to 25. So r from here we can get 5 meter. He is asking us to calculate the area for his curved surface area. We need to remember the formulas. So the area of curved surface would be a is equal to pi into r into l. So pi into 5 into 13 would be 65 pi meter square. That would be the answer. Now fifth question: how many bricks each measuring 25 centimeter and 15 centimeter into 8 centimeter will be needed to build a wall of 10 meter into 8 meter into 45 centimeter. Now there is one peculiar thing here. Everything is given in centimeter besides 10 meter and 8 meter. So we have to convert 10 meter into 1000 centimeter and 8 meter into 800 centimeter to bring everything into an even platform. The number of bricks needed would be the volume of the wall divided by the volume of one brick. So the volume of wall can be simply calculated 1000 into 800 into 45, and volume of one brick can also be calculated 25 into 15 into 8. So simply dividing the volume of wall by volume of brick, we can simply calculate the number of bricks. The answer would be 12,000 bricks. I hope the problems in this video, which would help you gain some confidence while dealing with problems from this chapter in future. Thank you.